through soap in your head.
What is that?
This is a shark stopper. It's a
Sonic. That's right.
We get to swim to the lovely sound. Wow. And you have everything you need from us.
I'm down from Santa Monica today.
Yeah.
It was on shore, a good 20 knots. I was going, that's not supposed to be happening.
Well, it
was. Same symmetry.
See you guys.
All right,
thanks.
Take care.
I'm off to the nearest Starbucks. Right.
Yeah, Big Thirst and Watered Angels.
Watered Angels.
I'm on it.
Really, really, really good.
This is the first aid kit?
This is like the go-to kit if you need some medication, zip ties, utility scissors, first aid kit.
So the general rules. Rule number one, the boat captain has the ultimate authority on the boat. He may call off a swim at any time because he perceives that anyone's safety may be in jeopardy. The observer is in sole charge of interpreting the rules during a swim. The swimmer or crew may not intentionally pollute the ocean with trash or debris, including but not limited to feed cups and gel packs, at any point before, during, or after a swim from dock to dock.
That what we're doing is very, very dangerous. I've done this for 22 years. I've done over 200 swims, and the rules or the procedures that I follow now aren't the ones we started with. They evolved. Every time we had a close call or did something stupid, we thought, oh shit, don't do that again.
I say clear. Clear means I'm going to walk out of the wheelhouse, show you my hands. I'm not going to put it in gear, go backwards, go forwards, go sideways. I'm not going to do anything. But by the same token, I've got no control of the boat.
If we're 300 yards offshore, Zach, that's going to take a good 5, 6, 7 minutes to get to shore.
Absolutely.
And so we need to get going sooner rather than later, obviously.
Going to do it. And then also the shark shields, the one for the ankles, they're all racked up and charged. So you just, it's right by the steps, they're all tied up. Just untie it, put it on, try to rinse it off, put it on. And then Tamie and I, in the morning, right in the morning, we'll set up that sonic thing. So we'll have everything set up.
I have no reception.
Huh?
I have no reception at all.
Okay, but you've still got a picture, that picture where Sissy Cove is.
Let me see.
It was taken as way off wrong.
It was not. We didn't.
And so I went by radar because you can't miss. Right. I went by radar. So, yeah. You know, I'm old school. So we have to be 300 yards off.
Going to, according to the rules, we have to be 1 nautical mile away from the San Nicolas Island, so we're just putting it together right now.
Cool.
We'll be assembling it here. We have extension cords to go right to the bottom of the boat, connect to an outlet, and then we're going to be just unloading the cables and dumping it in, and ready to go. Our swimmer is out there.
That's what we're doing with him. So he'll be protected. Most of the speakers will be on this side.
If there's any current pushing us up or down, they're overcoming it, so we're keeping it pretty straight.
Are you ready?
That Santa Barbara, that little speck to our our left, and as our left, Santa Barbara should be to our right. And I start looking at it. This don't seem right. And then I start playing with the radar, and an hour later, I see a blip at the top of the screen on the 24-mile scale, and I tune it in. It's an island. It's a big island. It's San Nicolas Island, and it's over here.
Oh,
I'm
no.
I'm going there.
Are we clear?
Ah, I got hit right here. Oh, it's screaming. But it lasts about a minute or so. And a few little ones here, so put some Vaseline or some lock and kind of cover yourself up. Oh, they were stoked.
Yeah, but
those guys are so bored. This is the biggest event of the day. They were like all coming down just to find out what's going on. Yeah.
Jim McConica is in the water now. Swimmer number two.
Get to the boat. Way up.
Awesome suit. I'm not looking at your butt. Chung with Allen Ball kayaking off of San Nicolas Island. Out of the water. There is Stacey Warmuth with kayaker Bob Howell.
I saw something. I think it was a dolphin because you guys are talking about dolphins the whole time.
They over a kayak.
Yeah, it's hard to beat beef jerky. All those ladies at swim camp, beef jerky, remember, that's the thing. Not everyone knows that.
I think it's the weight of a man's heart.
It was the weight of a woman's heart.
Tequila.
Tammy might be the one with the really good
shit. Tammy's got three swims in the dark, though.
Clear.
Clear.
Clear, Tommy.
Thanks.
Oh, holy cow, that's way better.
I didn't.
In with Bob Howell kayaking. Glassy conditions, but strong currents. You look great.
It's like a lake. It's really nice. But I will say that that hour seemed like a long hour. I don't know why.
Theo goes, alligator! Or whatever he said. And I'm like, what? And you're going, oh, I'm going to get out of the water.
No, I shut my earplugs in deep so I can't hear it.
These guys just don't realize how fast I really am.
Are you excited?
Oh yeah, I am. I'm sorry.
And this is going to be the fastest leg, right?
Yes, it will be.
Yay.
Without a doubt.
He's watching her, you know.
Santa Barbara Island in the distance. Probably can't see Catalina, but we can. And that may be San Clemente Island or the far end of Catalina.
Oh, yeah! Yeah. You come back. That is some blue water.
It's amazing.
Keeping sun at 4 o'clock, he said.
Look
clear.
Ladder up.
Ladder up.
Yeah. Ladder great.
Up. Yeah?
Yeah, the water is so beautiful, blue.
We don't know the readings, but on Tom Ball and Stacey, they went 2.5 nautical miles in their boat cycles.
Uh-huh. Cool.
So we are ahead of 30-hour pace through the first five, and I'm going to find out about yours. I think you were about 2.5 nautical miles.
Pool swimmers live forever!
Can I just go down the drain?
Oh. No, that's why I'm gonna die.
Sharks won't go for lean cuisine.
Well, no, I'm hoping they do. They're hoping they're not.
Was there much phosphorescence or bioluminescence?
There actually wasn't.
Oh, okay.
When I first dove in,
uh-huh.
It was the amazing blue and the white of the bubbles. The contrast was amazing.
Huh. Cool.
Like, almost, the light of the bubbles almost blinded me. Like, I couldn't see for a second.
Right that way from us right now, off of Santa Barbara.
Yeah, clear!
Yeah, he's getting
his goggles on.
He's putting goggles on.
Okay, swimmers on board is. Are we clear?
Clear!
Clear!
It just tosses you around.
You want the lights off?
Yes, it blinds the. You can't see the swimmer.
Yep. I see if you're up.
Woo!
Not bad at all. Water was ridiculously warm.
Oh, that's awesome.
Before, I felt fast, but apparently hit a head current.
Sucks.
Is that true?
I don't know. We'll find out from Bob. Tamie Stewart in the water off the west end of Catalina. Nautical miles to go. Next.
I'm like, yeah, I'm next. Hooray,
he's
hooray.
Happy he's next.
Guys, it's less than a Catalina swim.
Okay.
We start Catalina 17.4. We're exactly 17.
Hey, Captain, are we going to hit some good current sometime soon? Maybe, possibly?
Can you arrange for that?
This guy wants to know what slot machine to play when he walks.
As a matter of fact, do you know?
When God
in McConica out there off the west end of Catalina. It's actually coming around the face of Catalina right now. Jim has just taken off his orange swim cap, probably because it's so stinking hot out there. Not much cloud cover today.
I'll be as fresh as a daisy for like 5 minutes.
I'm going so tired.
How are we doing?
Pretty good, almost at 2 minutes.
Take your mark.
No false starts, legal dive. Tag off.
Just after 9:30 p.m. Sunday, the bottom stretcher shuddered to life, backed out of its slip in San Pedro Marina, and headed for the open ocean. The night was warm, the wind mild, and team morale high. Whatever the Channel Islands God had planned for the deep enders was anybody's guess.
Undedicated ocean gods, you do not do anything less than walk upon the water when challenged by the surf and swell.
Stacy on leg number 5 of the swim off San Nicolas Island with Catalina Island in the background. 13.45 nautical miles left to go.
You might need the ladder.
Part about it, see where we're pointing at Vincente? And look how this island is going perpendicular with it.
Yeah.
Then it look a little funny with the land we're looking at.
It still's got some bounce to it, you know, like. But it was great. I can't complain. It's really good.
Cool.
Could you get into a rhythm?
Yeah, I can get, most of the time I can get a rhythm and then it'll knock me a few strokes and then I can get a rhythm. So it's pretty good.
Nightmare!
Good job, dude.
Starting round number 6. Nice! That's super. We haven't had a single kayaker topple the whole time. Pretty awesome. Zach Jirkowsky, Jim McConica on board. Are you guys excited for your next turn?
Yes, we are.
Yay.
Yeah, and Tamie,
I wish I was getting one more turn.
Tamie might, well, you might be the one.
You might be getting one more turn.
She might be the one to land.
Not right.
Look. But it could be, it could be Stacy too.
Could be Stacy.
I like that.
Good job. There you go, Zach.
Yeah, everywhere we wanted to put the speed on, this is it. So we don't finish in the dark.
Did you hear that?
Real slow.
What?
It's time to put the speed on. We put the speed on today. If we speed it, we'll be in for dark.
But you gotta get in the water to do it.
Huh?
It's all clear.
Why did they stand
on the water?
Goddamn it. Okay. When they know they're gonna keep going in and how
it's
we lost. Now we've lost. Jim.
Jim McConica out now. Swimmer number 2, round number 6. Was it 2 fins or 1 fin?
What's it doing with 5 feet?
Yeah, I don't think it's anything interested in them.
The crew chief dumped his broken chair.
Aww.
10 minutes to live! You
that 10 minutes.
I'm not sure if I should wear it or not.
Yes, wear it.
Why not?
We're looking to see you walk on the water.
You're not going to wear it?
John Chung decided he was going to not wait for the kayakers, so they went back to the 22nd Street waiting for him, confident that he would get to the beach, find his way with Uber, and find them drinking beer happily in the bar.
Yeah. Did you sign a waiver?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. Clear.
Now.
Clear.
Now.
Clear.
Okay, Jim.
Yeehaw.
Woo!
Yeehaw. Like a sheep dog.
Oop, there he goes. Go get Johnny.
I was breathing every fourth.
Uh-huh.
The whole way for the full hour.
Uh-huh.
And I never looked at the boat. And Bob was perfect. He stayed right on my right shoulder, so I could see him the whole way. And I just hammered.
Awesome.
It was good.
Woohoo!
So it was my best total yardage of any of my six swims.
What was it?
2.23 nautical
miles.
Oh, I need to write that down. Excellent. They're all there.
We lose
all
right. A mile out. Woo!
She's clear.
Okay.
453.21.
Good job.
I think that was great.
Woo-hoo!
Is that four?
Who was it?
No, it was some guy. He saw the article in the New York Times this morning.
And so I think he pictures. That was really good.
Followed the swim on the tracker and raced down.
That's cool.
Yeah.